She came into the party as Congress president by people's demand in the year 1997-98, I think 99, roughly that's the time. That's the time when, people were believing that Congress may have come to an end, you know, it had become a weakened party. We didn't have a national leadership. We didn't have a leadership that could put everybody together. We had had a, you know, bad time at the elections. In some senses, people thought that we had lost our core bearings of, a pro-poor left-to-center party. You know, what had happened at Babri Masjid had dented our image. And a fresh new face was required, and a face that represented the core ethos of the Congress, which is why Mrs. Gandhi was brought in. It was a time, if you remember, that as soon as she took over the reins of the Congress, the Bharatiya Janata Party and its various units went around town, you know, making all kinds of statements about her. And we all know that. I mean, some of it were extremely below the belt in typical, right-wing fashion. She overcame that. She overcame all the prejudices that the BJP tried desperately to build about her. She overcame the fact that, Congress was in a poor situation. She built us into together. We started winning states, and ultimately, in spite of everybody's projections to the contrary, we formed a government in the year 2004. There she showed an exemplary behavior in terms of not taking up the prime ministership herself. And she believed that Dr. Manmohan Singh would be perhaps the best person to lead us. She went through with that. So she also showed, a sensitivity and an understanding and a sense of responsibility towards governance, perhaps far beyond what we see in many other leaders in India.